Hey guys, it's Louise, and this is my recipe for one of my favorite snacks to have while I'm hanging out with friends around the grill or on game day. It's my recipe for bacon-wrapped jalapeno poppers. Jalapeno poppers are a classic. Everyone's had them. I think that most people, though, have had them deep fried. These are grilled. They're really easy to make, and you can also make them ahead of time. So you can have them in your refrigerator a couple days ahead of time, waiting for you. When your friends get there, throw them on the grill. Couldn't be any easier. So to make them, you're gonna start with the filling. I like to use three different types of cheese. So I use cream cheese, Parmesan for a little bit of a salty kick, and sharp cheddar. Then you're gonna throw in some scallions, some garlic, and some fresh herbs. Whatever you've got in the refrigerator is fine. Then you're gonna take a lime, add the zest and the juice of the lime, follow that with some cumin and some salt and pepper. Once you got everything in there, you wanna put the lid on the food processor and pulse it until it's just combined. You don't wanna overprocess it and liquefy those scallions. Just make it nice and chunky and beautiful. Scrape all of this out of the food processor into either a pastry bag or a Ziploc bag. If you're doing this ahead of time, you can go ahead and throw that in the refrigerator. If you're doing it the day of, you can leave it out. It's much easier to pipe it into the jalapenos when it's soft. Now for the jalapenos. Cut off the tops, and then you're gonna scoop out the insides using either a paring knife or a small spoon. If there's a few seeds kicking around, it's totally fine. They'll just add a little bit more heat to the final result. Once the jalapenos are prepped, go ahead and fill them with some of that cream cheese mixture. Continue doing that till all your mixture is done. Line them up on a baking sheet. If you have a little bit of extra cheese mixture left over, put it in the refrigerator. You can always smear it on toast the next day. It's totally delicious. And now for the best part, the bacon. You're gonna wrap the jalapenos with the bacon, starting lengthwise. You're gonna take the bacon up and over the top and then take it around the sides. Secure the bacon with some toothpicks and you are ready to head out to the grill. Make sure your grill is nice and hot, then give your peppers a quick spray with some nonstick cooking spray and toss them on the grill. You wanna let the jalapeno poppers hang out on the grill for about 15 to 20 minutes. You know, you don't wanna burn the bacon. It's really imperative that the bacon cooks somewhat slowly and that the pepper also cooks at the same time. And it's not rocket science, you know, if they look like they're cooking too much, move them to a cooler spot of the grill, flip them over, rotate it. This is an ongoing process while you're hanging out with your friends, everybody's taking part in it, so just keep an eye on them. Once those jalapenos are done, take them off and put them on a platter. If they'll make it that far. Most of my friends eat them straight off of the grill. However, if you get them to the platter, garnish them with a little bit of lime, a little bit of cilantro, and sit back and enjoy with a nice ice cold beer.